Any other, do you think any other fears that would block you right now from taking it? There have been a lot of options that have opened up for you, darling.
Yeah, if I could have like a more all-round thing of how to make it work. So at the lowest common denominator, there's, let's say, X, there's a recurring deposit. And then one could probably explore some mutual fund, but that takes a longer horizon.
Tell me something specific. What are you looking at? I mean, do you have a number in your mind? Do you have a plan? Are you going to take up a course? Or are you going to do some voluntary work? I mean, what do you exactly, if you can give us a little highlight on that?
The plan, and this has always been the plan, which just keeps getting pushed forward, is to take a program at London College of Fashion.
Okay.
It's more of a personal growth kind of a thing. It's not not related to anything else. So that will cost money. The cost of living in a foreign city all by yourself, that will take some money. There are some costs which will keep going on while I'm even when I'm not here. So I feel that if I have 15 lakhs in a year, if I have 15 lakhs, like I'm saying, without it burning away, then I'd get the confidence to take that leap.
Okay. And do you have a time period before by which you have to like do it, or like high time, or is it like now?
No, I'm one of those practical people. I'm not very pro risk. Mm-hmm. I'm willing to say, okay, I'll work towards it for like a year or so, and then and I'll do it like in a calm and structured manner, so that I have no fears and no anxieties while I'm gone, that oh my god, did I do this right, and I should have done this and I should have done that. I'd rather plan for it and do it in a well structured manner.
Okay, so Dari, I want to bring in the angle of tax into this whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. See, what happens is when we are tax and inflation, both actually. So whenever we're looking at any number, by the time the time comes to spend that money, sometimes it rises in cost, and that's because of inflation.
Sure.
The other thing is, whenever we are providing for something, we need to budget for a little higher, because when we get that money, the government of India will want its share out of that. So, you know, the tax is going to go away.
On my sabbatical?
From everything, right?
They should be paying us, for that time. We pay taxes, give us some
But you won't be paying taxes for the sabbatical.
That's a really great point.
So when you are saying you're looking at 15 lakhs, my thing is look for 20.
Correct.
Okay?
Given inflation, given taxes.
Given inflation, given taxes. See, taxes straight away, if you get 20, 30%, and if you are, let's say, 20% tax, you want to be left with 16.
Mm.
So, and then 15 to 16 is a little bit of inflation adjustment.
See, that's what happens. The target just keeps moving.
Exactly.
Keeps moving. You never
so
really know
we overestimate
how to,
the target.
Yeah.
So we always overestimate expenses. We always underestimate the inflows. And that way we have cushions everywhere. So when we have to really spend the money, and when we are faced with a situation of doing and managing the math, we don't get hit or we don't get surprised.
Right.
And things don't get postponed in life for us.
Yeah, but he also stated that you need to understand that when you're taking the sabbatical, you cut back on the basic living expenses.
Absolutely.
You don't live like a king. You don't make certain choices, and you make them differently. So actually, your day-to-day expenses are also lessening.
So it's a practical.
It's a two-way
plan.
It's
not a romantic thought of one day I will just walk away.
If I were to ask,
it's a practical plan to make your romantic plans work.
Yeah. It's a very simple question. Do you think you can make space for about 60,000 a month?
Hell no. I could make 30.
Okay.
30, 40, yeah.
Okay, so 30, 40, and
I could save that much, right?
Yeah, so let's just multiply it by 12 so that everybody understands and you understand without putting in complex mathematics.
Yeah.
So if you can do 30,000 a month, it's 3 lakh 60 a year.
Right.
And in 3 years, you'll be sitting on about 11 lakhs.
Okay.
And I've not even taken interest into consideration.
Right.
Say with interest, it'll become 12, 13.
Mm.
So you're kind of near that figure. Assuming that in the next year and the year after that, your income will also rise a little bit. You might even get a bonus somewhere down the line. You might even do some restructuring of policies if you have, or you might do some restructuring of some expenses. Maybe instead of if you like to go out to expensive restaurants, maybe you'll go there twice instead of like five times, something like that. Because somewhere you need to, there is always a give and take, right? So you give something to get something back. I mean, there's a law of life, what you do. So when you do this kind of a little bit of replanning, maybe your 30,000-40,000 budget can be pushed to about 45 or 50, and you'll be at 15 lakhs very easily in 3 years' time.
3 years' time.
That's it. You first thought of a sabbatical 10 years ago?
Yeah.
It's been 10 years. We've got 3 years, we've broken it down to 3 years. Given inflation and everything, actually.
Yeah.
10 years ago, 15 lakhs value was about 20 lakhs. Yeah. So, it's
but
totally possible.
It sounds like it can be done. Totally possible. If you break it down into chunks and
different variables.
We are talking of a very, very simple thing.
Yeah.
A simple recurring deposit. So for everyone who's looking at it, do it in a recurring deposit. I mean, there's no rocket science about it. Very simple, right?
Yeah.
You can do something better also. There are some better options for you. You can go into what is known as a liquid fund or a short-term fund. Mm-hmm. So that is a part of a mutual fund, but that's not an equity fund. So what these guys do is when you give them money, they take your money and that money they invest into a range of fixed interest investments. Example, Government of India bonds, state government bonds, they invest in company fixed deposits, they invest in bank fixed deposits, they invest in RBI securities. All of these are something which pays you an interest for making an investment. So now instead of you making all these investments yourself, and some of them could have very high levels of ticket price to even invest in, give it to a mutual fund, 10,000
liquid
a liquid fund, and a short-term fund.
This doesn't need to be timed.
No, there's no question of time. Read up on it.
Yeah.
See, the advantage of doing that is it's going out of your bank account electronically, automatically, on a fixed date every month. And it instills a lot of financial discipline in your life, and automatically, you know, your sabbatical fund is getting ready.
There you go. He said, you're making your own sabbatical fund.
I think this is now suddenly becoming bite-sized chunks which can be done versus like one big number,
lot
which
of
sounds
options.
Like so
and
hard
for the
to achieve.
People who have a larger amount of money available right now, let's say you have some savings of 10 lakhs or 20 lakhs you've already made, there's something called direct bonds also, right?
Okay.
Now, what happens is, this is a little interesting. You can make a fixed deposit. You have a choice of doing that and you'll get the 6-7% on a fixed deposit that's available in the market. You can also buy a bond of that bank.
Okay.
But the ticket size for that normally is 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 40 lakhs sometimes. Sometimes it, for a small amount, it's not available. But if you had 20 lakhs, you could buy an RBI bond paying you 6.5%. It's as good as earning 10%. Or you could buy a, you know, a State Bank of India bond, or you could buy a Bank of Baroda bond. Typically, these bonds give you 1-2% more than your fixed deposit.
Okay.
Okay. They change in price a little bit, but don't get worried too much about it. They can move about 2-3%, 5% sometimes in capital value. But broadly speaking, if you're going to hold it for 3 years, 5 years, you're okay. You're immune to it. So you could buy that, but you have to buy that through a stockbroker from the stock exchange. So the stock exchange does not only give you shares, it also gives you these beautiful bond opportunities to invest in. And nowhere we are talking about risk, nowhere we are talking about volatility, nowhere we are talking about losing your money.
I had no idea of this.
Yeah, I had no idea.
These are simple, easy to do things. You can do it yourself. And if you have a financial advisor, well, it's a good idea to consult somebody before you take the plunge on your own.
There you go. There's a lot of options.